Hey guys, Robert Rowe here. Real quick, we want to talk about front side stability, trunk stability, stability in general. Okay, so I see a lot of breakdowns with guys in the breakdown of the glove side mechanics. And although, yes, it is a movement pattern that is broken down, that obviously we want to work towards obtaining an efficient movement pattern, but more than likely it's due to an either past instability issue or a present instability issue. We see with this with a lot of young kids. So just to give you some context on stability, it allows the individual to not only express force, but control it, absorb it, essentially authentically use force and energy, right? So obviously you can imagine if we have instability issues, then we have issues with force and energy. And if you have an idea of what throwing is at high power output, there's a lot of energy and force to be used, stabilized, and expressed. So we want to make sure that we're going about this efficiently, because as I mentioned, a lot of times instability issues coming up as like a young kid, obviously coming through high school and so on and so forth, instability issues can cause movement pattern breakdowns. And we just want to make sure that we're nipping those in the butt early, so then it doesn't become a huge hard process to then obtain efficient movement patterns later on. So this video will be kind of some progressions that we can utilize to help with the stability. Obviously we want to get the required stability to express certain forces, and then also some progressions that we can do to better equip us to instill movement patterns that are efficient, okay? Even though we don't have the required stability, we're working towards obtaining it, okay? So my favorite progression that we can use for front side stability is counterbalance work. 2 pound, 3 pound counterbalance work, throw it in your glove. If you don't have a glove on, put it in your hand. I'm a huge advocate with a lot of my clients with front side breakdowns, trunk stability breakdowns as well. Just play catch with the overload in your glove hand, right? Because what we see is when we give stability, even though the athlete doesn't possess it at that time authentically, meaning their body cannot stabilize through space, we give them an overload, counterbalance, 2 to 3 pounds, maybe sometimes 4. And what you'll see is that they have now the stability to absorb, express, control force. Okay. And then this is crucial for us, because we want to make sure that the patterns that we're feeding our brain coming up with every throw variation that we do is efficient. All right. So I just say, hey, counterbalance, let's play catch, dude. And then over time, these patterns just naturally clean up. So typically what you'll see with an individual who has this front side breakdown is they go into their throw and they do a pretty good job initially of establishing front side direction, and then front side just kind of bails out and is not even in the equation throughout the whole throw. And so what you'll have is inconsistencies in the release slot, you'll have trail leg hip flexion, you'll have early launch, limited shoulder extension, just inability to express the amount of force that we need to express to increase our power output, right? If you don't have like a ball, this is a 5 pound dumbbell. I don't recommend a 5 pound dumbbell, but like a 2 to 3 pound dumbbell, if you wanna do some like throw variations with this, right? And you'll see that you'll start naturally kind of getting more front side connectivity closer to your body. And this is gonna help aid in your ability to keep your trunk neutral throughout the entirety until you anchor down, allows your arm to get more inside 90 and to leverage your arm into your release slot, to get into a release slot on a consistent basis, so on and so forth. Obviously, I'm saying a lot of really good things that are occurring if we can have the required stability of the front side. So again, make sure that we're working towards obtaining that required amount of stability. But in the process, we can use certain modalities to help us aid in those efficient movement patterns, so we don't, you know, go deeper down the rabbit hole of these breakdowns. You can also use like a wrist weight counterbalance if you want to throw that on to do your plyos and stuff. And then I use, shameless plug, I guess I am sponsored by Axio Training, but Axio 360 here, this is a great tool to express and showcase where your breakdowns are with your front side stability, right? So you require a certain amount of stability within the front side, glove side mechanics, trunk, and over time, if we can really hammer that stability to do that control those movements through space, then we're going to be better equipped to increase our power output due to the ability to express, control, absorb all of these forces that are occurring throughout our bodies when we go into our throw, okay? And Axio 360 is a great tool to help freaking gain that stability. I can't even freaking do it. And then I'll include in the description, or I guess you can just search my YouTube channel for like some front side stability exercises and more drill progressions that you can use. But hopefully that video helps and you can work towards becoming better. See ya.